I love to tell the story of unseen things above, of Jesus and his glory, of Jesus and...
In the life of Jesus, from time to time, a conversation would lead to a Bible lesson. Questions asked to him, or sometimes requests made to him, he would take that time and bring forth a wonderful spiritual lesson. Today we're going to read one of those in Luke, the 12th chapter, verse 13 through verse 15. I'm going to teach on this subject. The word is covet, covet. Luke 12, verse 13. And one of the company said unto him, Master, that word means rabbi or teacher, speak to my brother, that he divide the inheritance with me. And he, Jesus, said unto him, Man, that word means in English, mister, who made me a judge or divider over you? And he said unto them, Take heed and beware of covetousness, for a man's life consisted not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth. Just a remark made, just a request made, and Jesus takes that time to teach on the subject of covet. First of all today, a request that set this teaching in motion. A request that set this teaching in motion. It's back in verse 13. When the company said unto him, Master, speak to my brother, that he may divide the inheritance with me. And that was a simple request. He recognized Jesus as a rabbi or teacher. His request was, Would you please ask my brother to divide the inheritance with me? And that's a request he had to Jesus. So instead of just going ahead and making a decision, he began to teach a lesson today that you and I need to understand ourselves. Because the second point is a response that Jesus gives. Verse 15. And he said unto them. Now notice what it says. To them. Not just the one that asked for a land to be divided. He now turns to the others. And he says to them, Take heed and beware of covetousness. He tells all those around him, Take heed and beware of something called covetousness. But the request is, Will you please tell my brother to divide this land with me? And Jesus turns around and tells everybody around him, You better watch out that you don't covet. Now, a reality of life most people miss, back in those days and also today. A reality most people miss. Verse 15. Listen to what Jesus says. For man's life consisteth not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth. That's the main point he brought out. See, the brother wanted the land divided. He had an eagerness or wish for more than what he had. And Jesus tells everybody around them, says, Look, I'm gonna give you a lesson now. Y'all need to listen here. Beware what's going on here, because his brother has a spirit to covet what's not his. In other words, he wants more than what he's got. He believes the grass is greener on the other side. He wants that over there. So Christ says, Now, I'm going to give you a reality that most people miss. A man's life consisteth not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth. Think about that. Our life does not consist in the abundance of the things which we possess. Is that not life? A reality that most people miss. Because most people, including us Christians, you know, it's the abundance of the things that we're looking for. You know, it's more. It's bigger it's you know, we just got to get out here and get it. And nothing wrong, I've said all these years, nothing wrong with stuff unless stuff owns you, unless your stuff runs your life. See, I believe when God blesses his people, we are to be faithful stewards and use what God blesses us to bless other people. Think about that. As God blesses you and I richly, we can take those blessings and use them from God through us to bless somebody else. But most people, they just get all these things together and abundance of things, and they have this drive, once I get all of this out here, I'm going to find out what life's all about. Then all of a sudden, they got all that out there and still don't have life. They still don't have any peace. They're still not happy. They don't have any contentment. They don't sleep good at night. They don't enjoy the days. They really thought, if I could get some more, I might find out what life's all about. If I could drive what he's driving, I think I'd enjoy life. If I could live where they're living, I might enjoy life. If I could have the job that he's got, if I could just have that kind of job, I might find out what life's all about. If I could pastor that church over yonder, I might find out what life's all about. You see, it's a nonstop. And it drives us to a place in our life to miss what we have today. That's the sad part. It drives us into our life to miss the blessings we have where God has planted us. And we're deceived. If I can have that, if I can have her, if I can have him, all this abundance of things which I possess, I can find out what life's all about. If we could hear today the testimony of so many people who had that drive, who really got what they was trying to get, and now testify to us today how the life is not even real to them, it might change our minds. But Jesus says here, you know, you want the land divided? He said, everybody listen up closely. Listen very closely. Do not covet. Beware and take heed of the danger to covet. For once you get what you think you want, and once you get what you think you got to have, he said, listen, you'll find out the abundance of the things in your life that you possess will not bring you real life. You see today, just a normal day in the life of Jesus. Just a normal question. And he takes that request and turns everything around and brings us a lesson today in the 21st century that everybody needs to take heed to. Our life does not consist in the abundance of the things which we possess. Our life consists today, primarily should, and the Lordship of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We in God's kingdom, on our way to heaven. And every day we pass through this world, we are pilgrims passing through, looking for a city whose builder and maker is God. Jesus said, I want you to have life. I want you to have life and have it more abundantly. It's not out there. It's in here. As you and I look toward God. Until next time, from Clark's Chapel Baptist Church, we trust for God's help that you would have wonderful days.
And his love, I love to tell the story, because I know 'tis true. It satisfies my longings as nothing else can do. I love to tell the story. 'Twill be my theme in glory to tell the old, old story of Jesus and his love. I love to tell the story. know it best. Same hungering and thirsting to hear it like the rest. And when in scenes of glory I sing,